light are big and bright. Deep in the heart of Texas.
Let's go down to the heart of Texas and check in with ABC News correspondent Jim Ryan. Jim, good morning.
Good morning, McGraw. It's not so much the stars, but the stars and bars that are attracting the attention of some folks around here. There's an organization out in East Texas, the Sons of Confederate Veterans, that would like to see a Confederate battle flag offered as an element on a specialty license plate sold here in Texas. Last year, the state collected $17.5 million from the private company that markets these specialty license plates, everything from your high school or your college to different organizations. And this organization, the Sons of Confederate Veterans, think that that one of the specialty plates should incorporate the Confederate flag. The justices heard arguments, could have a decision by the end of June.
So the state of Texas said, no, we're not going to allow this plate, correct?
That's right, yeah. They say that it's offensive at best and downright inflammatory at worst. And so the state of Texas, also they want to try to protect their brand, so to speak. On every license plate, specialty or run-of-the-mill, is the word Texas. And they'd rather not have the state of Texas, or at least the name Texas, associated with something as controversial as that.
The Sons of Confederacy say it's a free speech issue.
They do. And to that end, Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg asked an interesting series of questions. She says, okay, so let's say you are allowed to sell these Confederate flag plates. Would you also have to market, or could you market, a plate that has a swastika on it, or the word go jihad, or something like that, you know, and testifying on behalf or arguing on behalf of the Sons of Confederate Veterans? And the attorney said, yes, you probably would have to in the name of free speech.
Did anybody bring up the fact that it's the flag of another country, and the objection Texas is a part of the U.S. and it's not the part of the Southern Confederate States, and therefore why would they be forced to put a flag of a different country on their license plate?
It's a good point, but I mean it's essentially a country that doesn't exist anymore, right? I mean,
right.
The Confederate flag that is similar, I guess, to the British flag or the Australian flag, but it's its own thing and looks different from those others. So that's a good point, you know, and maybe something that the attorneys bring up in further arguments as this goes forward. But for now, the justices will sit on this. They'll come out. And I'll tell you, there are 9 other states where the Confederate flag is offered as a specialty plate, and they'll certainly be watching this carefully.
How what's the conversation going on in Texas? Are there people in support of the Sons of Confederacy, and how local are they, or how vocal are they, I should say?
Well, they are vocal, and consider this. The Sons of Confederate Veterans are in league now and have the full support and legal backing of the American Civil Liberties Union. Strange bedfellows there, but they're both fighting for this on grounds that it's a free speech issue. The Sons say that it's about Southern heritage. The ACLU says it's about the First Amendment.
As Ted Cruz chimed in on this.
I think he had comments about it yesterday, was asked about it, and I don't know if he's had a response to it yet or a firm answer, but I'm sure that it's something that will come up as he launches his presidential career.
Yeah, when are the justices going to make this announcement, or when are they going to rule on it?
Should be before the end of the summer. They're looking at potentially in June coming out with something.
What about other local officials down there, the governor, the mayors, senators, anybody else chiming in on this?
Well, it's kind of a party line sort of thing, and the more conservative you are in Texas, I think the more you're likely to support having this potential specialty plate out there. The more liberal you are, then the less likely, I suspect. But again, it's made for some interesting bedfellows in terms of politics. The ACLU, coupled up with this organization that wants to see the stars and bars incorporated onto specialty plates.
Interesting times we live in.
Yes, sir.
Jim Ryan, ABC News correspondent. Thanks for checking in, Jim.
Thanks, McGraw.
You got it. 858 here, Big 550, KTRS. I don't see how they...
That's interesting that he said that 9 other states have these...
Allow it.
I didn't know.
I didn't know that either.
Well, that's already set a precedent then.
Well, it's never been. But I think the precedent is that the state says no.
Yeah.
And so in these other states, the states didn't say no.
I can't believe this. The other states didn't say no.
That's really interesting. Again, I think it's different. It's different when it's state sanctioned as opposed to We talked about this yesterday, the Ku Klux Klan sponsoring a mile on the highway to sort of clean it up. Mm-hmm. There, the state can't discriminate. But are you going to tell me that driving down the road, you're going to see a I Love ISIS license plate with the state of Missouri on it? I mean, that's just... That's,
I mean, if they rule in favor, then it could be any...
Right.
Group.
Right.
Any group.
Yeah. I mean, what a disaster that would be. And so there's got to be, I can't, you know, stranger things have happened and what, who knows what, but I just can't imagine that they would allow that to be, that the state must be forced to put a different a different country's flag on their license plate.
I don't know.
All right.